Exploration aims. The high number of mission explorations to Mars clearly points out the importance of Mars within the solar system. Thus, the question is, why this great interest in Mars exploration? The interest in Mars is due to several practical, scientific, and strategic reasons. In the practical sense, Mars is the most accessible planet in the solar system. It is the second closest planet to Earth, besides Venus, averaging about 360 million kilometers apart between the furthest and closest points in its orbit. Earth and Mars feature great similarities. For instance, both planets rotate on an axis with quite the same rotation velocity and tilt angle. The length of a day on Earth is 24 hours, while slightly longer on Mars at 24 hours and 37 minutes. The tilt of Earth axis is 23.5 degrees, and Mars tilts slightly more at 25.2 degrees. Further, Earth and Mars revolve around the Sun with about the same revolution velocity. The former orbits at 30 km per second and the latter at 24 km per second. A year is 365 days on Earth and almost double that at 687 Earth days on Mars. Both Earth and Mars have four seasons each. Severe dust storms occur during the summer in the Mars southern hemisphere. They are so strong that block most of the surface from view by satellites. During the fall, in the Mars polar regions, crystals of carbon dioxide, CO2, form and so much of the atmosphere gets absorbed that atmospheric pressure drops up to 30% as seasons transition from fall to winter. From the scientific point of view, it is worth noting that exploring Mars provides the opportunity to possibly answer origin and evolution of life questions and could someday be a destination for survival of humankind. In fact, the red planet is a stony body with atmosphere, like Earth, with the same age, yet with only half the diameter of Earth, and with similar geological structures, as cold and desert-like surfaces, mountains and volcanoes, lava plains, cratered areas, giant canyons, wind-formed features, ancient riverbeds and, a very important thing, the presence of water. Therefore, Mars could provide several information about what the Earth beginning was and, especially, what the future expected to Earth will be, if climate changes arise and persist. Finally, in the strategic sense, exploring Mars demonstrates political and economic leaderships of a nation, improves the quality of life on Earth, inspires young generations, and helps learn about our home planet. The first successful approach to the red planet was with the flyby of the U.S. Mariner 4 spacecraft, SEA, on July 15, 1965. The Mariner spacecraft. Credit, NASA. The flyby mission allowed getting the Mariner 4 space probe very close to Mars so that it was able to collect photos of the red planet in passing, SEA. They were first Mars images ever returned to Earth. Photo of Mariner crater on Mars taken by Mariner 4. Credit, NASA/JPL. Since then, more than 50 missions were planned and partially successfully accomplished. The Mars exploration, in fact, is characterized by a high failure amount, especially the early attempts. Roughly 30% of all Mars missions failed before completing their goals and some failed even before their observations could start. As is well known, Mars missions represent a great success for aerospace engineering because they feature several complex phases, like launch, interplanetary journey, approach, entry and descent flights, and landing. Each one is unique and demands great efforts. These exploration missions answered several fundamental questions, such as dispelling the myth of canals that evidenced an ancient civilization and investigated the antique riverbeds present on the surface, which suggests the presence of liquid water and maybe of past life forms, which may lie hidden below the planet's forbidding exterior.